little bit of damage right here. Nothing that a little Bondo and some duct tape can't fix. Ed and Ella should be proud of us. We chose one of the safest places to park this van. Good vehicle. I'm glad we have a fleet of 10 of these.
All right, well, it was nice talking to you, Mike Perry. We'll have to get back in touch with you and find out more about what's going on in the Miami area.
Sounds great. Nice to be with you, Dan.
Yeah, nice meeting you.
A bit of damage here. What is it?
What?
This would be on the west side of the building that we're at. The storm came out of the east.
Don't learn a lesson now.
My name is Jason McCourtney.
This is where we stayed for the duration of the storm. There's about 150 people that stayed down this hallway.
Another memory in the making?
Yes, sir, a Kodak moment. Look at this. All I can see is your silhouette.
Are we going to get to watch it when we come back?
The number is 565-5400.
The salad bar exploded in Burger King.
That used to be a Amoco gas station right there.
Why it says Amoco.
From the hurricane, Hurricane Andrew has now reached 8 persons.
Hi, Jamie.
According to Fred Taylor, the director of Metro-Dade Police.
The Allstate claim number is 1-800-767-9717.
As you can tell, we're having massive earthquakes right now, too. That's why the camera moves so much.
800-767-9717. That number again is 1-800-767-9717. If phone service is not available, you can stop by the nearest Allstate office or see your Allstate agent. Now, let's talk about insurance for just a second. Of course, the Allstate, they let us know exactly how to handle it. Now, they're going to come in, like
most
of the companies, and have a setup to handle this very massive insurance situation that we're going to be facing. But if you don't happen to
deal on a Honda
today, or you don't happen to make your claim, that they'll make their official decision. Right now, you got a couple days left to school. Okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right, bye-bye. Okay. Let's go to line two. Okay. Where are you at? Go on. Where are you?
Kendall.
Yeah, Kendall, we just heard from Kendall. It doesn't sound too hot out there.
Yeah, especially in my neighborhood. All the roofs are caved in my neighborhood.
Which is
in El Hammock, number 4.
U-Haul.
A lovely U-Haul.
A lovely U-Haul. They keep on running. They never need maintenance. I was sure to be the individual that rented this U-Haul and parked it in the wrong position.
That guy's going to catch hell in the morning.
His credit card company is not going to like him anymore.
Oh, deal on an Acura over here.
There's some serious damage right here with this Acura dealer. All the windows have been blown out.
Well, you know, as a matter of fact, I saw
Man, why didn't somebody just get out, lift that thing up? Let's get out and lift that up.
Get a phone number for the American Red
Want
Cross.
To?
They need volunteers in both Dade and Broward County. You'd be doing a great service.
How did you find this out?
I have a friend who attends yours, man. I spoke to
him. We're at International.
What about down in Homestead? You said you had some information.
Kentucky Fried Chicken has been totally...
The Colonel's bumming.
Yeah, the Colonel's going to have a secret recipe for that.
Not to go back, they would make an announcement and let them know when they are to come back, but they are not to go back to Homestead Air Force Base yet.
Yeah, well, we haven't heard anything to the contrary, so I guess we'll stick to that. And you got a question?
And then I have a question about 95 of the turnpike. If they're clear and open up to West Palm Beach International Airport.
Well, the latest that we heard is that they are definitely open in Dade and Broward County, so I don't see any reason why they wouldn't be open.
Come on, thanks.
You can see them right there.
100.
Hello.
I'm walking around with M16 machine guns.
Listen, I had an uprooted tree.
They chased some little black kids out of there.
No real damage except uprooted trees and things like that.
There's a bank.
I called all my other friends.
Once again, they were at the bank trying to loot the money. The further south we get, the worse the devastation is.
Working to get as much power going as fast as they can, so please be patient. You know what we got to do? Let's check back the storm center down on Channel 4
right now.
See what's going on
down there. We're approaching Cutler Ridge, yeah.
We're still looking for information on Key Biscayne, the island.
Set up shop and start working with people immediately.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, you will be able to start contacting, I think, as we start to get through to
We're dodging power lines left and right.
About where people can contact
we got
this
a lot of power lines down
we're
here.
We're just trying to get through today right now.
You can see we got power poles, light poles.
We've been watching this happen to other people, and now it's happening
More damage
to
over here to this,
that one family
this
that we
shopping mall.
That's happening to
broken glass everywhere.
Thousands and
people across Dayton, Delaware County.
Hey, Masters Carpet. There's a lot of looting going on here.
Oh, the Triple X movie place got destroyed.
You
gotta
help your neighbor. There's no more porno. Tommy Lane's in the world starving for excitement.
We don't want you going anywhere tonight, and there's a curfew. And if, you know, your house isn't that badly damaged and somebody down the street has got a tree through the front door, we ought to give them a hand.
Right.
You know, at least let them get somewhat of a decent night's sleep.
And we really don't have, it's 2:30 now. And
here's this Amoco food shop. Amoco, yeah. Once again, we're at Cutler Ridge area. This is where the Walpers, Sam Walper, the base director, his home's in this area.
Exactly.
We'll be showing that here real soon.
Miami, Coconut Grove, we got a report just a short time ago.
We have a Hardy Service Department. I didn't know we had one.
Urging people who don't live in or have a business in Coconut Grove or downtown to stay out of those areas.
This is a Pizza Hut. Here we got a sub van upside down.
And earlier today, you correct me if I'm
wrong. No more delivery.
There was a perimeter for everything south of Kendall.
This is a semi trailer that
Kendall with Marianne Murciano
destroyed
in the Dade emergency office. Do we know that that perimeter
just
is
totally smushed? Totally smushed. Just debris everywhere. It's hard to describe it.
Report to Larkin General Hospital immediately. You are needed.
Sizzler's food shop.
Kmart.
We have a Kmart. Now we have to Texaco.
All right.
Okay, now we're looking for the Wamper House.
There's Denny's, it used to be.
We we're looking for the Wamper. We have a car upside down here on its side.
Development residents don't go to North Shore Medical Center.
We're going to be cruising into the Wamper's house now. We're going to stand by. We have a car that didn't quite make the hurricane.
What?
People are just driving chaotically. They don't have their heads where they belong.
They're not naming their child Andrew, but
probably something in the Z selection.
There was about 275 women there when I was there last night.
The death count for Hurricane Andrew is at 8 right now. 8 people have died. They have discovered a dead body in this area right here.
I don't know, about 20 births yesterday.
In the Cutler Ridge Mall.
In the Cutler Ridge Mall, that's true.
Everything is going well.
To Wamper's house, there's a lot of
people.
Oh, take a look at this. Yes.
Here's our road.
A lot of destruction here, folks.
I wonder.
South of Kendall Drive.
Hey, you can see we had to do a little four-wheeling to get through here. Up into people's yards.
It's just
unbelievable.
That's what I'm trying to
do. That makes this a hell of a lot more exciting than what NBC News will.
Only on the east portion. We'll have to find that out.
Okay. Stand by here, folks.
Go to the airport tomorrow without checking with your carrier.
Okay, you can see once again.
And again, Jerry, about President Bush.
President Bush is going tonight to the Opal Airport at 5 o'clock.
Okay, this is the street probably the Wampers live on, correct?
We don't know.
More federal help cleanup efforts after he sees it for himself.
Oh, yeah, plenty of
that. As I told you,
you can see, folks, this is the eye of the hurricane hit this area.
The backhoes are all out trying to clear the roads, and that holds up cars for quite some time. Let's go to Metro Traffic's Mitch Grant. Mitch, how's it look out there?
And thanks a lot, Brian and Jerry. Right now, we have a report of a collision going southbound on the turnpike in the Melbourne area.
Sure,
as you could imagine, that's tied up traffic.
Right before the school, that thing is left.
Cam's place, it's looks like an elementary school or a high school.
Drove all the way down to West.
Here we are. Reunion time. How you doing, Tom?
Not too hot, man.
Hell no.
see the other side of your van there, pal?
Yeah, well, in a minute.
You better take
poor Tom, man.
I even took a picture of it as a memento.
Hey, this is the Hegeman family van. Looking pretty nice right now.
I make you a special deal.
Let's take a look, take a walk around this guy.
They were just in my house. They had a credit card. They weren't my daddy's own work, so they unified it. They said it's on their way here.
Hey, watch out, Brian.
There were some people with like three TVs in the back of the truck.
It's not looking real great. Let's take a look inside here.
Well, I agree.
Boy.
See those crews?
Looks like a mess to me. No, we got coverage, Brian.
Oh, dude, Brian, you know, we saw
here.
A car, a tree about that size fell on the car.
Well,
it was hating.
Come
it.
On in and get out of here. The floor is all flooded.
Shit.
Windows are out. We are. We're walking into one of the bedrooms here. Okay. We got major water here. Major water. Right here's where the rocks were helping the window, or the wall here. All of the carpets are soaked with water here. Here's the bathroom.
Steve Savalini's.
Yeah, would you get make sure, you know,
oh, yeah,
the leaves
on
my wall,
yeah.
And it's dripping, and my ceiling dripping.
And these two awful dogs that we inherited.
There's leaves all over the walls
this
here.
This one's cool. This one's crazy. She did real well.
Yeah, she
night.
Did. We would have heard her all the way from the other
no,
hallway.
She did not.
We got water dripping from the ceiling here.
She didn't bark if you would have heard her.
Water stains, ceiling sagging.
Look here, Tom. Well, I hate to leave you.
Windows broken.
Oh,
that's
windows.
Right.
All
of
it.
Dude, we can handle it.
Scenario.
Stay right here.
Windows broken out here.
There's a sapling.
At least Tom
next to the area last night.
They're all over here, four of us in this corner, dude. Just right, and they're over there.
Okay, we're walking into one of the back rooms here. Water's standing everywhere. Everywhere, there's water. There's probably about 2 inches of water standing here. Windows all broken out. Leaves on the walls. If you look really close, you can see the water damage from the roof. Ceiling is sagging, water dripping from it. Lots of leaves. All this is leaves and another type of debris everywhere coming through the windows.
Harry, Bob and Duke are here.
This is the one that they all took refuge in for the duration of the storm. This is the one that's least damaged. The windows are intact. They do have some water standing on the floors in the bathroom area. Just very, very minor damage in this room.
All right, this is the backyard. There's Tommy.
Great if you can do it.
What's a common sense direction to go?
Get on the turnpike. That's the best thing I can tell you, friend.
Just take 41.
Can't see a thing. Okay, it is Tuesday the 25th. We are still in the hurricane shelter. Pat, you want to say anything?
We are so dirty. I have the same pair of underwear on for 3 days now. I'm getting pretty rank.
Okay, let's take a look at our provisions we have left. We've got water. Got Pop Tarts coming out of our butts. This is our stuff that we've provisioned separately for us, since we don't know where we're going or what to expect, since we haven't heard a peep from anyone. Tommy, you want to say anything?
Yeah, coffee.
Okay, give you an update later.